This vid tip is for Penny Abernathy's Leadership in Digital Media Economics, and it's about how to use the Bloomberg terminal. I'm going to talk about how to find company data in the Bloomberg terminal, a little bit of industry data, some analyst recommendations. And using the Bloomberg is a little tricky. It's not web-based, it's all text-based, it's great for librarians and other kind of data geeks who are not into a graphical interface. I'll show you some screenshots. So the first thing you do is you find your company, type in the name or the ticker symbol, and then you have to type in these commands below. Here are some of the ones that are particularly useful for Penny's class. FA is company financials, which includes things like income statements, balance sheets, earnings estimates, and more. I'll show you some examples of those. Analyst recommendations. So there's two ways to get those in the Bloomberg. One is ANR. Those are one word recommendations, buy, sell, hold. And then the other one is BRC. I'm going to look up what it stands for, which I think is Broker Research Reports. I'm not sure what the C stands for, but Broker Research Reports. And those are 1 to 4 page reports by independent analysts, and those you can download as PDF. You can get a nifty looking graph of historic stock prices. You can get SEC filings from pretty much anywhere. Obviously, they are in the public domain, and the Securities and Exchange Commission makes them available. If you're in the Bloomberg already, it's really, really, really easy to get them out. If you're not, get them somewhere else. But I just want to point out that this is something that's very easy to get once you're in the Bloomberg. And industry research you can also do while in the Bloomberg. So if you're having trouble finding information about your industry, this would be a good place to go. The top three I really, really recommend, company financial analyst recommendations and the graph of historic stock prices, is what I'm going to focus on, but I will show you some of the other stuff as well. So here is a screenshot. This is what the Bloomberg looks like. I don't know if any of you has ever used this before, but I will try to point out some things here that is really useful. It's taken me a couple of years actually to figure out some important things here, but I will point out, you're looking over here are the data elements that you're looking at. Here is the time period. So these are estimates for 2014, 2013, the current, the last, so my guess is this is the last filings, so their last quarter filings. This is Disney, and you can tell that up here, Walt Disney Co., comma, the. This is last year, fiscal year 2012, 2011, and you can use these arrows to go all the way back, and I think it goes back 6 or 10 years, so you can get some really, really good data here. And it goes down a little bit further. Here's the scroll bar. So it goes down a little bit further. There's even more data. I don't know what EBITDA is, but I know Penny likes it. So here it is. You can graph any of these things here. If you just click on it, it's just a plain old bar graph, but you can do several things at once if you want to. Get some interesting visuals for your papers. We are in the key stats tab here, and in key stats we're looking at highlights. There's also summary, enterprise value, multiples, benchmarks per share, and stock value data. So you could just click on those and you would see even more. And then here is income statement, balance sheet, cash flow, ratios, segments, and more material. The periodicity, which is a new word for me, is annual. You could change that. You can download this as a PDF. You can download it as a graphic. That's what I did. And you can download it as an Excel file. If you've ever been told that we could not download it as an Excel file, that's changed. So now you can download all this data as Excel, which is very cool. And again, I just wanted to highlight that you get even more resources for the Disney company here. And so here is the balance sheet. You can see now it's a change tab. And you get different things down here. And here are all the items. You'll notice that this screen is a lot bigger than the other ones, so you get a lot more information if we were able to scroll down. Again, by year, so FY 2012 and earlier. You can also get charts if you wanted to. This is something called segments. This is again for Disney, and I did by geography. So here we're looking at revenue from the US, from Europe, from Asia Pacific, from Latin America and others, and so on. Revenue, operating income, assets by area. So kind of once you kind of get a sense of what you're looking at, it starts to make a lot of sense, particularly if you're text-based. But once you know what you're looking at, it's a lot easier to use. It's overwhelming at first. But that's one of the reasons I'm giving you these big screenshots and so many of them. So there's the geography. This is analyst recommendation, and you get a chart of the price over time, the stock price over time, how many people say buy, hold, and sell. And then here's the firm name and the analyst and the recommendation. This was for the New York Times. I think I did this last spring. You can see charts over here. You can see the date that they made the recommendation. And if you clicked on this, you would see more about the analyst and the other companies that he or she is analyzing, and you would get their contact information. So you could get in touch with them if you wanted to. There's the recommendations. This is another way of looking at analyst recommendations. So over here, you can download these as PDFs or Word documents to see their recommendations. And here there are seven, eight page reports. Here's who's doing the rating. And here are the changes and revisions and so on, and the dates that they last made their recommendation. This is pretty. This is historical stock prices. And this, I think, is just 6 months. So here's the time. This is for the Washington Post. Here's for April 2012 to October of 2012. You can change the time frame here. And this, just for the visual people, gives you a really nice visual of the data. And here is a Bloomberg industry report. You get a lot of news here. Bloomberg News is huge. So here's Bloomberg News, a little chart, some key indicators, TV revenue, affiliated revenue, film revenue in that industry, some metrics, and some of the competition. So this isn't necessarily the first place I'd go to get industry data, but if you're in the Bloomberg, if you have a chance to come and see it and use it, you may want to just try it. It doesn't cost anything extra. It doesn't cost anything at all. So, which begs the question, how can you find a Bloomberg terminal? How can you use one? We have one at the Park Library, so anytime we're open, you're welcome to come use it. I would recommend making an appointment if you can find a buddy in your class to come with you. Even better, it's complicated to learn. It takes me about 20 minutes to kind of go through and show you that stuff. But then you would probably want to spend another 20, 30 minutes doing some research. You can download the data, as I say, as an Excel file, as a PDF, as a graphic. I suggest doing all three. And email it to yourself for later, so you don't have to do the analysis. You just have to get the data. And if there's more than one of you at a time, of course it's easier for me, but you'll also learn it a little bit better, and you'll talk to each other, and that'll reinforce what you're learning. If you can't get here, you might be able to find one in my newsroom. 15 years ago, we had one. I'm not sure if newsrooms still have them. If any of you is in a newsroom that has a Bloomberg, then I would strongly recommend using it. A corporation, you know, a business entity might have one. UNC Charlotte may have one in their business school. Those are some of my ideas. Get in touch with me if you have more questions about that. It is something that's really, really going to help you do the research for Penny's class. So if you can get to campus, if you can get to UNC and use the one that we have, that's great, or see if you can find one somewhere that somebody would let you use. And if you have any questions, let me know. Thanks for watching this vid tip, and good luck in your class.